It's AumSum time!
Why do some people stutter?
Huh?
Wait, let me ask my dentist. Forget it.
Stuttering or stammering is a speech disorder in which an individual may repeat words, parts of words, syllables, phrases, etc., or even stretch certain sounds within a word. Why do you think this happens? In our brain, Wernicke's area and Broca's area control our speech and language. Wernicke's area helps in choosing the correct words to express our thoughts, whereas Broca's area is believed to be involved in producing movements in vocal folds, tongue, etc., allowing us to speak those words. Now, stuttering can occur if a brain injury or stroke either damages the Broca's area or reduces the blood flow to this region, thus not allowing it to produce movements properly. Also note that, during childhood, as the speech and language skills are still developing, children may suffer from stuttering and it will usually disappear with age. Why are some people double-jointed?
Because they are aliens!
Nah.
Huh?
A joint is an area where two bones meet with the help of ligament. Joints enable us to bend various body parts to a certain extent. However, some people can bend their body parts more than normal. Such characteristic is called joint hypermobility. It is said that hypermobility is because the individual has more or double joints which give him extended range of motion. However, this is incorrect. Hypermobility in some people is the result of flexible ligaments which enable their body parts to bend more than normal.
Dude, that really looks creepy!
Besides this, hypermobility can also be seen around ball and socket joints, which involve the ball-shaped end of one bone fitting into an indentation on the other bone. The shallower the indentation is, the greater the range of motion, thus giving that individual hypermobility. Why do some people sweat more than others?
'Cause they like the smell of their sweat.
Oh, gross. No. Sweating or perspiration is a very essential process. Sweat absorbs heat from our body and evaporates, thus helping us regulate our body temperature. Now, during exceptional situations, such as on a hot day or while exercising, it is okay to sweat more than usual. But some people keep on sweating even under normal conditions. Such excessive sweating is the result of a condition called hyperhidrosis. In this condition, the sweat glands overreact and produce more sweat than necessary. Besides this, caffeine in coffee and nicotine in cigarettes also make us sweat more. In addition to this, men tend to sweat more than women.
Why do some people have a fear of flying?
'Cause airplanes don't provide giant burgers.
Nah. One of the reasons for this is claustrophobia, the fear of being in enclosed spaces. Now, when in a car, a claustrophobic person can open the windows and not feel trapped. However, in an airplane, he can't do this. Hence, he experiences claustrophobia in an airplane. Second is not being in control of the situation. For example, a car is in our control. We can get down at any moment. But since the plane is 30,000 feet above the ground, we have no control over what is happening. Also, as planes fly at high altitudes, they are built to handle cloud turbulence. But when a person experiences such turbulence, it can make him anxious and increases fear of flying. Besides this, media broadcasts the news of crashes over and over again, thus influencing us and creating a fear of flying.